Good morning, Akshay. You can chat in the chat box. Very good morning. Good morning. Good morning. As I said in the mail, you are muted relating to audio and video. If you want to say anything, then in that case, I will be giving you the audio right. Okay. But when everybody will be there, and if everybody starts speaking at the same time, then nobody will be able to understand anything. So while conducting the class, I mute all the students, and then you can say that if there is something they want to say, then they can say, they will ask me, I will give them the audio right. Yes, good morning. We will start after around 5-10 minutes. Let others join. By that time, if you have anything specifically to be asked, you can ask. Anything to ask? Any specific question? Good morning, Amit. Good morning. Very good morning. Very good morning. Good morning. Good morning, Amit. Good morning. Good morning, Tanu. Very good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Yes. Good morning, Tanu. Very good morning. We will start after 5 minutes around. Before that, if there is any specific question, you can ask. If you want audio right, I will be giving you the audio right also. No issue. Anybody has any specific question? Akshay, Amit, Tanu, any specific question? No, good sir. Good morning, Tanu. Good morning. Tanu, anything specifically to be asked? Any question in your mind? Not necessarily related with the syllabus. Anything? Okay, thank you. Let's start now. But there is no, you are saying IFRS. Actually, IFRS 4 and IFRS 17 are not relevant for this year. As per the syllabus, because they are not yet examinable documents as per ACCA syllabus guidelines. Good morning, Rakesh. Good morning. Good morning, Sripana. Good morning. Good morning. IFRS 16 only, not IAS 17. Even though in the notes it is there, why it is there, I will be telling you. But we are required to refer IFRS 16 only. Sripana, you need to select Sripana. Need to select audio as instructed in the mail. If you don't select the audio, you will not be able to hear me. If you don't select the audio, you will not be able to hear me. And not require to log in from two machines. Okay, let's start. For first half an hour or 40 minutes, I am taking you to the institute website and I am showing you so many things are given on the institute website freely. We don't have to invest a single rupee. We don't have to invest a single rupee for purchasing material or anything. Whatever is required, that I have already shared. Now there is endless things available on website, because generally the student asks that, sir, how to write the answers, whether I will get the marks or not, what the institute require, what is the syllabus, which I need to refer, everything, all these things are there in the mind. There are so many videos on the institute website. There are so many materials. If we focus on those videos and materials, we will understand obviously that what we need to study, how to prepare the syllabus, how to pass the exam. That we will understand everything. Okay. So before starting anything, we have to go to the institute website. I have already opened, but I am opening for you separately. accaglobal.com. The website name is accaglobal.com. In the accaglobal.com, you need to go under students section. Under students section, you need to go into the fourth one. Good morning. Study support resources. Under student, you need to go under study support resources. In study support resources, some they always do like this. What I am saying, it is creating disturbance. We are not following the mail instructions. Never why we follow mail instructions. If you don't select the audio, how you will hear me? Same thing is happening with all the three students. Pranveet, Somyadeep, Sriparna, all three, if you don't select the audio, how you will hear me? How can we become a practical person in life? How can? We will never become a practical person. Because whenever we are getting any document, any mail, anything, we don't have the methodology or thing to read. Why? Now she is saying he can't hear. You understand? What should I do? You, everybody, tell me. At the same time, it's a request from my side to everybody. Please, when you are doing chat, in the chat box, there is written to. There is a drop down. From the drop down, select everyone and then chat. Then why you are not reading mail? Never. Yesterday only, day before yesterday, again now. It is written in the mail categorically. What is written in the mail? What should I do? How can we do the things in life if we do like this continuously? What is written in the mail to everybody? Anyone, a student, can log in through only one machine, computer, laptop, mobile phone, anything. If you will log in from two machines, you will be removed from the class. While login, you will be asked to mention your name. Before login, please write your full name. And while login, it will ask for the audio to be used. Please select that. Otherwise, you will not be able to hear anything in the class. But we are doing the same thing. Last thing, in the live class, audio and video of the students. You have to select, because if you don't select the audio, how you will hear me? are muted so that the class can be conducted properly. If required, we will give you audio right in the class, and please remain them mute only in the class. I have written everything in the mail, but we never follow. But you can log in from mobile phone also, there is no problem. It's not that we need to log in through the computer only. We need to select audio, then only we can log in. What Amit is saying, do that. But that is very normal thing. In this technological age, if we are not so much technologically friendly, how can we work in any organization? So now we are starting. Can we start now, or we should waste our time like this without reading the mail, without reading the instructions? If we join in the class and disturb the class, should we do that or should we start? Everybody is okay. Should we start the class? Yes. So first of all, we should be going into accaglobal.com, that is the website of the institute. In that website, we need to go under student section, because for the time being we are students. Under student, you should always go into the fourth option, study support resources. Under study support resources, you click, then you are getting three options. One is ACCA qualification, one is foundation level, one is diploma in IFRS. Under ACCA qualification, you will get the knowledge of all the 13 subjects and everything. That is the full qualification. Foundation level is applicable for those who are in 11th and 12th standards, not even 12th pass out, or those who are non-commerce graduate, because they need to give some different papers. That is not different than ACCA qualification, but there is a separate heading for them. And diploma IFRS, those who are not doing the ACCA full qualification, they are just want to interested in doing the IFRS, IAS, then diploma IFRS, they can go. I am going into ACCA qualification. In ACCA qualification, all the 13 subjects are there. The first three subjects are treated as fundamental and knowledge level. Then after that, the nine subjects up till financial management, six subjects up till financial management is skill level. Then in professional level, there are two compulsory subjects. Strategic business reporting, strategic business leader, and out of the four balance optional, we need to select any two. We need to give exam for any two. For the time being, our focus is on strategic business reporting. So I'm going into strategic business reporting. Under strategic business reporting, there is a study support guide, that is how you can start. Tips for success, study plan, guidance on how to use the resources and all that. Then there is syllabus. Like suppose Akshay was asking IFRS 4 or 17, which one is applicable. Then they have written that what is the subject for the time being, the aims and objectives of the exam, planning outcome. Retake guide, if somebody failed or somebody did not give exam prepared earlier, how can he prepare better? Examinable documents. Relevant legislation or standard tested in the exam. Here also it is written what is the course for which we are going to study. Then how to approach the exam, please feedback on past performance, that is for all the terms when the exams held till now. The exams held till June 2019. June 2019 is not updated now because the results is not out. But other than that, up till March, all you will be getting here. Then there is some support from BPP, Kaplan. There is nothing there. You can buy the material of BPP or Kaplan by going here. Then specimen exams, that how the exams will be coming, What will be the paper setting and everything? Past exam papers, their questions and their solutions along with the solutions. Technical article, there are some regular developments, maybe not relevant in the syllabus, but regular developments which comes in the ACCA magazine, that is here. All are regular developments which is happening in the world relating to this subject. All these are there. Then FAQs, still you are not satisfied, you have still questions, then you can go into FAQ, you will understand. Generally, they give last 5 terms results. But since the strategic business reporting exams held only 3 times up till now, one is September 18, December 18, and then March 18, March 19. The fourth exam is June 19, which is over. They always give the last 5 terms results. The result is pretty good. 47, 47, 49%. On a standalone basis, many persons or many students or many faculties also consider that so easy. 50% of the students are passing, so simple to pass. It's not that. If in Indian course the pass percentage is 5%, 10%, 15%, and here it is 50%, it is very simple. Indian course is very difficult. That is not the case. Because I understand from the basics that why this is the case. If in Indian courses also the exams will not be on 6 monthly basis, not for group wise, that is 4 exams or 8 exams, if they will also start taking the exams on quarterly basis or according to your demand, you will study one subject, then in Indian courses also the pass percentage will be 50%. It's because of the system, because of the structure. For that reason, the pass percentage is lower. When we give exams, we are preparing 4 subjects at a time. Maybe in one of the exam, we are not able to do it properly. So the entire group is not passed for that reason. Definitely, according to my knowledge, Indian exams will also be like this. Not now, in 5 to 10 years, computer based and everything. Then in that case, in Indian courses also, the results will be very good. It's not that the syllabus is less. If anybody has studied the SBR up till now, anything, or deep IFRS, you will definitely find that the syllabus as compared to any Indian course is very, very large. If I will say on a 1 to 10 scale in Indian course, the syllabus is 5, it is more than 10 year. So there is no less syllabus. It is more syllabus than what you study in Indian course. But since we study accounts today, we will study accounts tomorrow, we will study accounts day after tomorrow, every day we will study accounts. So that gives us comfort. At the same time, the exams frequency are high on quarterly basis. So even though if we don't give the exam in one term, then the next term, the period is not getting wasted. Generally, those who are in professional level, they can easily complete the professional level if they are serious in their life in maximum 9 to 12 months. That is by giving one exam, one quarter wise. So that system is easy. For that reason, the pass percentage is higher. It's not that it is easy to pass as compared to Indian course. Not like that. We have to study properly the syllabus, everything. Then only we can think that we can pass the exam or we can score high marks. And according to me, when we are studying only one subject, getting 50 is not the logic. I should be getting 60, 70, 80. I should be trying to get the world rank 1 or at least India rank 1. Because when we are studying one single subject, along with our work, job and everything, we can properly study for 2 hours in a day without disturbance and everything. If we study regularly 2 hours, there is no problem of passing this exam because you will be studying one subject. Now, out of these materials, that is aims and objectives of the exam, suppose I am going into syllabus. In the syllabus, first of all, I need to choose a version. There are 2 versions for SBR exam. One is UK version, one is international version. Those who are from UK, they select UK version because there are specific developments in UK that they need to know in the exam. But those who are not from UK, generally they select the international version. We will be studying on the basis of international version. Now you can see that strategic business reporting SBR international syllabus and guide from September 18 to June 19. June 19 is already over. This material is relevant for June 19 exam, till June 19 exam. Then the strategic business reporting syllabus and study guide from September 19 to June 20. That means we are going to give exam in September 19. But whether we give exam in December, whether we give exam in March, whether we give exam in June 2020, there will not be any change in the syllabus. That will remain same. That is by the institute. It's not I am saying. It is written there. Ki whatever changes happened up till now, they will be examinable in coming four terms. New things will not be examined. Now this material, if you download, I have already downloaded so that I don't have to use internet of the institute. That means the more internet will not be used. I have already downloaded this material. SBR International, September 19 to June 20. This material I have already downloaded from the institute website. It is written September 19 to June 2020. Why this is the case that this is 1 year theory and all that? Why this is the case? I am not reading everything. Just for the sake of our understanding, I am reading the relevant areas. They are saying guide to ACC examination assessment. ACC reserves the right to examine any learning outcome contained within the study guide. This includes knowledge, technique, principle, theories, concepts as specified. For the financial accounting, auditing and assurance, law and tax exams, except where indicated otherwise, ACCA will publish examinable documents once a year to indicate exactly what regulations and legislations could potentially be assessed within identified examination session. For most examinations, not tax, regulations issued or legislation passed on or before 31st August annually will be examinable from 1st September to 31st August of the next year. That is the institute guidelines. For that reason, whenever June is over, you will always find in the website there is a new document which is saying that the syllabus for next four term. Obviously, in income tax, if somebody is giving in professional level UK taxation exam, then there may be some changes in between also. They are specifically mentioning. At the same time, if we read the general guidelines, they are even saying for IFRS, for auditing standards also. But that will be generally by notification. From where we will get that? There is, as I shown you that, there is a development in the universe, whatever the new guidelines and all that, sometimes they publish. But that they mail to a student also, they mail to us also. Okay, please, when you are teaching, when you are training to the student, consider this. This will be the examinable documents. Maybe we are not referring that mail regularly, but regularly they update to students if there is anything, something changes, which is beyond these guidelines. Then if we go into the syllabus, the financial accounting we study, maybe suppose we are doing this as an exemption, but financial accounting FA, which I will start in my classes tomorrow for 12 pass out students, undergraduate students, this subject. Then financial reporting, which is skill level financial reporting. Then comes strategic business reporting. That means indirectly the institute want to say that the student need to have knowledge of these two subjects fully for going into strategic business reporting as per the institute guidelines. If suppose somebody is getting the exemption, but still they need to have the knowledge of this area. Because for that reason, the exemption is given. And then they are saying that if somebody will be giving in professional level the auditing paper without having knowledge of SBR, auditing paper cannot be tackled because auditing and accounts are always correlated. So for that reason, SBR knowledge will be required in auditing paper also. So if somebody will be selecting the optional paper auditing, then SBR knowledge will be fully relevant there. If somebody will be giving auditing exam, say after 6 months, 9 months, you need to study at that time SBR again. Not for the exam purpose, you have already passed. But having knowledge of SBR, then only you can tackle the auditing paper. Always they see that how the entire syllabus is related with this area, with this subject, with this particular subject that they are saying. Then they are saying, the ACCA qualification does not prescribe or recommend any particular number of learning hours for examinations because study and learning pattern and styles vary greatly between people and organizations.
This also recognizes the wide diversity of personal, professional, educational circumstances in which ACCA students find themselves. As a member of the International Federation of Accountants, ACCA seeks to enhance the education recognition of its qualification on both national and international education framework and with educational authorities and partners globally. In doing so, ACCA aims to ensure that its qualification is recognized and valued by governments, regulatory authorities, and employers across all sectors. To this end, ACCA qualification is currently recognized on the education frameworks in several countries. Please refer to your National Education Framework regulators for further information. I will advise all of you, you do Google search that in our country, the national regulators, what they are saying, the RBI and all that, everywhere ACCA course is a listed course. Even the deep IFRS also. Each syllabus is organized into main subject area headings, which are further broken down into greater detail on each area. Now, if we go into the detail of the area, before going into detail, if I will go into professional level, guide to ACCA examination structure and delivery mode. Under professional level, strategic business leader, which is not the subject for the time being, we are studying SBR, is ACCA case study examination at a strategic professional and examined as a closed book exam of 4 hours. The strategic business leader case study exam is a 4-hour exam, including reading, planning, reflecting, time, which can be used flexibly with the examination. There is no pre-seen material, information, and all exam-related materials, including case examination exhibits, are available within the exam only. A strategic business leader is an exam based on one main business scenario, which involves candidate completing several tasks with which additional material may be introduced. All questions are compulsory, and each examination will contain a total of 80 marks, technical 20 marks, professional skill. The other, that is we are not doing, we are not studying a strategic business leader this 3 months. That is, we are focusing on other strategic business professional exams. The other strategic professional exam like SBR or any paper, all of 3 hours and 15 minutes duration. All contains 2 sections and all questions are compulsory. These exams will contain 4 professional marks. 96 marks will be the paper, 4 marks will be for professionalism. For September and December 19 session, all strategic professional exams will be assessed by paper-based examination. From March 2020, every time a student asks, but never read the website, what is there freely available. From March 2020, these exams will become available by computer-based examination. For September and December, they are copy and pen based. From March 2020, exams will become available by computer-based examination. More computer-based, more detail regarding what is available in your market will be on ACCA Global website. With applied knowledge and applied skills exams now assessed by computer-based exam only, ACCA is committed to continuing on its journey to assess all the exams within the ACCA qualification using that delivery mode only. The question types used at strategic professional again require students to effectively mimic what they would do in the workplace with the move to CBE. That is, in the workplace, we are working on computers, laptops, SAP, Oracle, we are not working on copy pen. For that reason, the exams are computer based. These exams again offer ACCA opportunity to focus on the application of knowledge to the scenarios using a range of tools, spreadsheets, that is Excel sheet, processing and presentation, not only enabling students to demonstrate their technical and professional skills only, but also their use of technical availability to the today's accountants. ACCA encourages students to take time to read questions carefully and to plan answers. But once the exam time has started, there are no additional restrictions as to what the candidate will decide. Time should be taken to ensure that the information and exam requirements are properly read and understood. The pass marks for ACCA in entire curriculum, all the papers, 50%. Out of 100, we need to score 50. I always say in every my conversation with all the students that from next year, they will be starting the professional level also computer-based exam. But according to me, it is very easy to pass computer-based exam than a copy-pen-based exam. If you are writing something, I am not understanding, I am not giving you any marks, But in computer-based exam, there is no question of handwriting. So they have already communicated 1.5 years back that from 2020, they will be going for professional level also computer-based exams. Now, they are saying that Section A will consist of two scenario-based questions that will take 50 marks. The first question will be based on the financial statement of group entities or the extract thereof, and is also likely to require consideration of some financial reporting issues, syllabus area C. They are saying that the first question of 50 marks will be divided into A and B, 25 marks each, that will be tested from syllabus area C and D. Candidates should understand that in addition to the consideration of numerical aspects of accounting, maximum 25 marks, a discussion and explanation of these numbers will also be required. That is, in 50 marks, it's not only numerical. Half is numerical, half is theory. The second question in Section A will require candidate to consider reporting implications and ethical implications of specific events in given scenario. How this will be dealt with, I'm coming. Section B, students will be required to answer further two questions in Section B, which may be scenario or case study or essay based. That is, may be scenario based, may be a case study, may be a question, may be a theory, may be some numericals, will contain both descriptive computational elements. Section B could deal with any aspect of the syllabus, not only CD, any area of the syllabus, but will always include either a full question or part of the question that requires the appraisal of financial and your non-financial information from either the preparers or the shareholders point of view, because the financial statement of a company are the public document. So we need to think from the stakeholder point of view also. Two professional marks will be awarded in this Section A and B, 2 to 4 marks, which is free. Free in the sense professionalism. The current issue element of the paper may be examined in Section A, B, but will not be a full question. It is more likely to form part of another question. That current issues we will be getting from the website regularly if we refer the website. Now, if we go into the syllabus, they are saying the part A is fundamental ethical principles. Now, ethical principles not like auditing, integrity, objectivity and all that. Principles like you have studied in your basic accountancy, if I will say bookkeeping, separate entity concept, duality concept, relevant concept, then you can see accrual concept, going concern concept, those concepts are explained as per ACCA guidelines. Those generally we study in ACCA AB level. When the student find a problem in this area, I generally ask them, you can refer my ACCA account, financial accounting class in which I teach this area. But they are testing that as a separate guidelines, even in the strategic business reporting also. Okay. How we will be tackling that, what we'll be doing in the class, how you need to study, you need to give me 10-15 minutes further. But I'm just going with the syllabus. That is fundamental ethical and professional principles. B is financial reporting framework. The application is strength, weakness of the accounting framework. Under B, basically they have covered the format of the financial statement. PL account, balance sheet, notes to accounts, statement of changes in equity and all that. That is theory, this is format. And in explaining the format, they have set certain, you can say IES 1, IES 8, they have explained those IES. Then reporting the financial performance of a range of entities, that is C area, which will be tested in first 50 marks. In part B also, but in part A 50 marks, this will be tested. Revenue recognition, which is IFRS 15, non-current assets, there are 7-8 accounting standards in that. Financial instrument, that is, what is financial asset, financial liability, their disclosure, their treatment, their measurement, leases IFRS 16, employee benefit IS 19, income tax IS 12, provisions, contingent liabilities, contingent assets, IS 37, share-based payment, IFRS 2, fair value measurement, IFRS 13, reporting requirements of small and medium-sized entities, there is IFRS, I forget the number, and other reporting issues, recent issues. That is, maybe there is something written in the IFRS, but are you satisfied with that? Do you think that there should be some changes happening? Because this paper is not only what is there. This paper is, as a, you can say, as a knowledgeable person, can you see that this should not be there? There should be some different thing. It's a highest level of exams. Then in part D, there is financial instrument subgroup entities, consolidated cash flow, consolidated financial statement, subsidiary, joint ventures, associates, change in group structure in Indian context, which can be said as chain holding and all that for a subsidiary. Then interpretation, you can say financial statement is given. Can you understand the number? Can you analyze the financial position of the company from different aspects, from liquidity, from solvency, from profitability, from different stakeholders point of view? That portion is not only, you can say, knowing with the figures. With the figures, can you judge the financials on non-financial grounds? Non-financial aspects also, okay? Now, if I will talk about, you can say, IFRS, those who are doing IFRS. In their case, the group cash flow is not there. In their syllabus, group cash flow statement is not relevant. In their case, foreign subsidiary is not there. They don't need to study foreign subsidiary. In their case, change in group structure. Some area is there, some area is not there in their syllabus. That is specifically written in deep IFRS course level. Then if I will say this E and F is not so much in detail in deep IFRS. It's basically financial analysis, non-financial analysis they are not covering. And if I will say the part A, that is there, but the questions are very less in deep IFRS exam relating to part A. So I can say that the extra portion in SBR, strategic business reporting, each part A more detailing. In part D, group cash flow, foreign subsidiary, then in changes in group structure, there are areas which are not there in the syllabus. And in part E and F, basic financial analysis, the detailed financial analysis is not there. But I understand that whenever I teach the SBR or deep IFRS, those students who are doing the SBR, they are not doing just for passing the exam. If you go in SBR, the pass percent, if you go in the diploma IFRS, the pass percentage is even higher. It's around 55-60% in average, 10% more. Generally, the student don't fail in deep IFRS exam unless and until he has not studied anything. There are students who have studied, I can just say that, you can say in 3 to 6 months, slightly, and at the end, they studied 10 days very well. They passed the exam. Amit is an example, you know that. And others also. There are many who pass the deep IFRS exam, but SBR is not that type of exam. It is high level exam. It is not just saying that just knowledge in numericals is enough. You have to go into deep for passing the SBR exam. When I am covering the SBR syllabus, the deep IFRS is automatically covered. There is nothing separation required, because in deep IFRS, there is no extra syllabus. Whenever I will be in a class teaching something which is not in deep IFRS, I will be telling in the class that this is not relevant in the deep IFRS. But for the time being, I'm just saying that the part A, the ethical principles are not so much asked in the IFRS exam, deep IFRS. Then in part D, the group cash flow, foreign subsidiary, and changes in group structure is partially not relevant. And in part E and F, I can say that the basic financial analysis is there, but the non-financial, you can see current situations and all that, not so relevant for the deep IFRS exam. So whenever I will be dealing something relating to that, I will be telling in that class that this is not relevant for deep IFRS. But according to me, we should not think about what is there, which is in the syllabus. We are doing this so that we can work in any organization in the accounting department, maybe a controller of accounts, that we want. For that reason, we are studying. For that reason, we should not take into mind that kya hai, kya nahi. When the exam will be there, we can ignore those areas. For the time being, we should focus on everything. Then the detailing of this, that is the same syllabus in further detail given. I'm not going into that, because then in that case, they are writing chapter wise. Just, Akshay, you were asking IFRS 4 and 6, 17. You will find that it is not written anywhere in the syllabus area. Since it is not written for the timing, it is not an examinable document. Now, if it may be applicable, that maybe in March 2020, it will be applicable. If it will be there, then we will be studying that. I will be sharing with you the extra class relating to that. So that for that, you don't worry. But today, IFRS 4 and 17 is not there in the syllabus. As per the institute guidelines, as on today, we can say 12th of June 2019. It is saying that there is no IFRS 4 or 17. Okay. This is one document which is saying you that what is there in the syllabus. Now, if I will go into another document, they have written relevant legislation or a standard tested in the exam. Then how to approach to exam, feedback on past performance that they have written. I'm clicking this. In this, there is a video examiner's report highlighting. I didn't like this video. Even though if I would have liked, I would be not using in the class because these are freely available. Examiner's approach article. How can you approach the exam? What you should be doing? Examples of changes in approach article. That is maybe something there is change that is covered. Exam technique for success. Exam technique for success. And then all the exams which happened, for all the exams, there is examiner's report. All the exams. All the exams. Every time the student asks, sir, mereko number milega ki nahi? Mere bhai isko padh liya. Free mein mila hai. Free mein. Believe me, I can say only one word. ACCA Institute website is fantastic. Fantastic. Everything is there on the website. You don't have to refer any material, anything, if you refer the website properly. Or it is not that if I am a registered student of ACCA, then only I can see. It is freely. Just you go into accaglobal.com, everything is freely available. Not a single website anywhere in the world of any institute is like this. Now, out of this, the important document which we should be using, exam technique for success. Because many times, kaise answer likhna hai, kya karna hai, nahi karna hai. This is a very important document. I have already downloaded this. I am reading this for all of you. Not this one second. Embracing change, shaping future, strategic business reporting, exam technique for success. Because we need to follow what they are saying. I need to follow in the class. You need to follow in your study. These are all institute material freely available on the website. But we are never reading these materials. Introduction, time management or your route through exam, format, content, preparation. The examining team for strategic business reporting summarizes their approach as follows. It will be better. So what they are saying, candidates will be examined on concepts, theories, principles, and the ability to apply this knowledge to real life scenarios. Whenever you refer any questions, maybe it's a question in the exam, believe me, with every question, you can correlate the practical world. It's not that we need to work there. They are always asking the practical problems in the organization relating to high level of accounting issues because it's a strategic business reporting exam. Whatever the problem is facing in finalizing their financial statement or some stakeholder is asking some question, how you reply to that as an accountant, as a knowledge of the accountant, vast knowledge of accounting. How can you deal with that situation they are asking in the exam? What does a good SBR answer look like? Everybody has this question in mind. Sir, mere ko answer kaise likhna hai? So they are saying, what does a good answer will look like? How do I achieve that? How can I achieve the best answer? There are two questions that will be on your mind, in my mind, in your mind. As you prepare for the exam, as we start studying, the answer to the first question, that is, does a good SBR answer look like? What is the good answer? That they are saying, to answer the first question is not as elusive as you may think. There are a number of identifiable criteria that make a good SBR answer. The answer to the second question, that is, how can I achieve that good answer? The answer to the second question is a resounding try of good exam technique. In this article, we examine these two close linked questions in order to provide you with a checklist of factors that contribute towards a good answer and techniques that can be employed to achieve them. Together with good technical knowledge, these techniques would put you at the form of Q when it comes to gaining a pass in SBR or gaining a rank. First of all, there are writing about time management and your route through the exam. Like all the exams within the strategic professional, there is no choice of questions. Whatever is there, you need to solve in SBR, but you still can and should make a choice as to where you start, which I always say whenever you ask me during the exam, before the exam, abhi har samay main ek hi baat bolta hoon. Dekho na, agar aapne mere se kabhi bhi baat ki hai, main ye baat bolta hoon. A good technique when starting the exam is to spend a few minutes scanning the questions to get a feel for them. It's a good approach to start with the best question for you. Now, the best question for anybody in the exam will be different. But for you, which is the best question? You should start from that. Getting a first good question under your belt will boost your confidence. Choosing a best question is a personal choice. I cannot comment. Nobody can comment. You need to choose. You might decide that you are well drilled in groups and so want to do questions. Question one first. You may prefer question two, or on the basis that the specimen exam and the examining team articles seem to suggest that it will have a relatively predictable style. Ye aapka marzi, aap kya karenge? Ye log bol rahe hain aapko start kaise karna hai? The question which you know very well, start from that. Having said that, I always say that ki I know this very well. That doesn't mean that if this is to be written in 10 minutes, I will be taking 20 minutes. Even the thing which I know well, I should be saving my time and utilizing in those areas where I don't know well that they are writing. Having said that, if you feel comfortable with the subject matter of a question, you may be more likely to run over on time. Because aapko aata hai, you will become carried away. 10 minutes is allowed. You are writing everything which is not required also. This brings us to a crucial element of exam technique, being time management. In order to have sufficient time to attempt all questions, you must allocate your time based on the marks available. 1 mark, 1.8 minute, 10 marks, 18 minutes. You can take maximum 20, but you cannot take 25 minutes. You must allocate your time based on marks available. Be strict with yourself and move on when time is up. Even though it is not finished, move on. Leave that, because the time is over for that person. It is widely accepted, not by me, widely accepted, that a student will gain more marks from spending 5 minutes working on a new question than from continuing to work on a question that have already spent the allocated time. If 18 minutes is allowed, you have already given 20 minutes. You will give on that question 5 minutes. You will not be able to score marks. In place of that, give your 5 minutes to the new question. I always say this for every exam, not for this only. In SBR, the risk is often that you will run over time, which has happened with every exam, not only SBR, working on calculations and have insufficient time to spend on the narrative parts of the answers. You are going doing the goodwill calculation. You don't able to write anything, which is where the majority of the marks tend to lie. The numerical are scoring less marks. The theory is going to give you more marks. You have not written theory. You have just done the numericals. You cannot pass. This is a particular risk in question one in group. That is the 50 marks part A. There are two parts. First part is mainly numerical. Second part theory. We are doing numerical continuously. We have not written any theory. We can't pass, they are saying. It really does not matter to marker what order the four questions in the SBR exam are answered. Regularly in every exam, you will see that 5-10 students are calling me, sir, main aage piche question kar sakta hoon kya? एक तो मैं पहले क्लास में बोलता हूं, दूसरा इंस्टीट्यूट का मटेरियल भी अगर आप नहीं पढ़े हैं, क्या पढ़ना है नहीं पढ़ना है, तो फिर क्या एग्जाम के लिए तैयार है? हाउ कैन वी सी दैट आई कैन पास द एग्जाम? इट्स इमटेरियल वेयर यू आर वर्किंग, दे आर नॉट गिविंग यू टाइम, दैट्स इमटेरियल. फॉर एग्जाम यू नीड टू बिकम ए स्टूडेंट, फॉर एग्जाम यू नीड टू नो द गाइडलाइंस ऑफ द एग्जाम. सो दे आर सेइंग आप कोई भी क्वेश्चन आगे पीछे कर सकते हैं, इट्स नॉट दैट यू हैव टू अटेम्प्ट दैट क्वेश्चन ओनली. provided that leveling of each part is adequate. Properly, question 1A, Roman 1. Proper heading should be there. But absolutely keep a good answer in that all parts of all questions are attempted. But absolutely keep a good answer is that all parts of all questions are attempted. Means that if I am doing 1A, in 1A, there is Roman 1, Roman 2, Roman 3. If I will do 1A, Roman 1 now, then I will do question number 2, 3. Then again, I will do Roman 1A, 2. That is not advisable. That should not be done. They are not saying they will not give marks. But why they are advising? Because in that case, your performance will be further bad. If you are thinking relating to a particular scenario at one moment, if you write the second answer, even though you don't know at that time only, it will save you time. Otherwise, we need to think again that they are writing. But absolutely key to a good answer is that all parts of all questions are attempted. However, this is not always as straightforward as it may seem. In some SBR questions, some requirements are implicit. For example, a question may require a discussion of financial reporting issues. However, the details of the issue in each sub-requirement are hidden in the scenario. How you will understand when we do question? Good exam technique is therefore to identify these sub-requirements or issues before starting the answer for any part in the first few minutes of a question and then estimate how many marks would be given to them in order that the remaining time can be allocated appropriately. Practicing scenario-based questions is the best way to develop this particular technique. You should review your answer carefully and consider what issues should have been identified and how you would have allocated marks to this. For understanding this, I am going into this only. They are saying that this is a question from a specimen paper from the institute website. What they are saying? Explain to the directors of Kutchen with suitable working how goodwill have been calculated on the acquisition of house, maybe you can say a parent company acquiring a subsidiary company, acquisition of house and March, showing the adjustments which need to be made to the consolidated financial statements to correct any errors by the financial director. Again, I am reading the question. Explain, that means there is a theoretical part. Explain to the directors of the company, parent company, with suitable workings, numerical also. Explain with the workings how goodwill should have been calculated. How goodwill should have been, you need to calculate goodwill also. You need to explain also on the acquisition of house, on the acquisition of a subsidiary. And showing the adjustment, there are two subsidiary acquisition, house and March. Showing the adjustments which needed to be made to the consolidated finance, that is also theory. The adjustment to be made in the financial statement when we are acquiring two subsidiary to correct any error which they have already done. There must be some error which is done by the company on acquisition that need to be rectified. How that can be rectified? That also need to be written. Now what the examiner is saying? A good approach in this topic of question is to produce the goodwill working on one sheet of the answer booklet. Suppose you started working, you make a two column, house and March. You started calculating goodwill for them. In one sheet, you are doing all the working on the sheet of the answer booklet and then take each line of the calculation, each line. Suppose goodwill calculation, we start cost of investment by parent in subsidiary. Then we start fair value of NCI. We get total consideration. Then we deduct net assets of the subsidiary. Somebody, those who have not studied this, they may not be getting. But those who have studied this anywhere in time, because you understand that all of you are getting the exemptions from the basic level paper F7 and all that. So slight, I am assuming that knowledge at least kuch aata hai. Mere ko dhyan hai. To mere ko pehle wo ek line ko pakad ke notes likhna hai, they are saying. A good answer in this type of question is to produce the goodwill working on one sheet of the answer booklet and then take each line of the calculation and explain it on the another sheet. The level of detail required will be driven by the specific question and circumstances. But issues might include, they are saying that, suppose you are writing cost of investment by parent in subsidiary. But what are the considerations which parent can pay for acquiring shares of subsidiary? What elements are included? Why each contingent consideration? What is deferred consideration? How is each element measured initially? Are they subsequently measured? Then they are saying next line in your calculation of goodwill non-controlling interest. Then what is NCI? How can it be measured? What are the impact of the measurement option? Then the net assets, because we need to deduct net assets to calculate goodwill. What are the basic recognition and measurement principle for net assets? Are there any exception to these principles? How our adjustment need to be done? For this, we need to know all the IFRS. Because when we take net asset, whether in the subsidiary, their inventory, assets are fair valued, IAS 16 and all that, all comes into picture. Then what is goodwill? What is an asset? Because when you last line is goodwill, then what is this goodwill? What do you mean by goodwill? Why it is an asset? That you need to see. Somebody will give the exam. Somebody will say that, sir, I have done the calculation of goodwill correctly. But out of the total marks, you may not be getting less than 50% marks. Why? Because the goodwill calculation, if you go in this specimen exam, is very simple. Kuch hai nahi uske andar. So goodwill calculation is maximum 30 to 40% marks. But either we are not writing at all, forget that, they are asking explained, or maybe we are not writing properly, marks will not be good. How can we improve this skill? Not by doing the question and reading their answer. For each question, we need to write our answers. When the chapter is finished, when there are 5-7 problems done in the class, the other problems, you cannot see the answer. You cannot see the solution. You have to solve the questions on your own. Aapko khud ko karna hoga. Aap agar khud nahi karoge, to nahi chalega. And when you write the answers, check your answer with the model answer. See that where you can improve. If you find that you are very good, still they are writing something else, then I am there. Then you need to show me that I have written this. Is this correct or not? Then they are saying that a good answer, a good written answer in SBR is not produced in an essay style. You started one page and in the last word of the page, it is essay you are writing. Small, small headings, subheadings, small, small paragraphs they are writing. It's not produced in an essay style. It should be laid out in a way that is clear and easy for the marker to follow. You could use an extended bullet point style in narrative SBR answers, working on the basis that a well-developed point will score one mark. A well-developed answer point is likely to include one or two sentences. You are taking a point, suppose from here, fair value consideration. Under fair value, you need to mention these four things. Either if you want to write about all these four things, you mention subheading, then you mention one or two sentences. If you want to write about all these four at a time, you can mention 5-6 lines about all these points, because examiner will give you marks on your writing, not just the numerical technical knowledge. They want that, are you understanding the concept or not? You could use an extended bullet point style in narrative SBR answers, working on the basis that a well-developed point will score one mark. A well-developed answer point is likely to include one or two sentences. Consider the two answer points that follow. John is acting unethically because he is asking Lucky to ignore IAS 23. In this specimen paper, there is a question on IAS 23. So one of the director is saying to the accountant, to the head of the accountant, ignore that. IAS 23 follow nahi karenge. IAS 23 requires that borrowing costs are capitalized only if set criteria are met. John is acting unethically because in order to increase profits, he is asking Lucky to capitalize borrowing cost that IAS 23 requires to be expensed. The two reasons effectively make the same point. However, the greater level of detail given within the second point is required in order to secure the marks. The first answer point does not demonstrate or understanding of the requirement of IAS 23 or the motivator for the unethical behavior, whereas the second answer point clearly what he's saying. You must write sufficient point to score at least a pass in a given requirement. Therefore, for example, in a 10 marks question, a minimum of 5 points should be presented, but on the basis that not all of these may score preferably 7 or 8 points. This does not, however, mean that the quantity is more important than the quality. The content of the points must be good, or else there is a little point in written writing them. That is, they are saying that there is a 10 marks question and you need to justify that why the expenditure can be capitalized, cannot be charged to PL. You have justified points. Generally, you should be writing for a 10 marks, 5 points. Many times when we are writing a point, it is a repetition of the old one, or maybe it is not relevant, you will not be getting marks. So maybe you need to write 7, 8 points so that the relevant 5 points the examiner will give marks. But that doesn't mean that the quantity of the answer is important. You need to check with your time. Whatever time available, in that you need to finish. But they are advising. That way we should be writing the answer. So far we have constructed on the format and structure of a good answer to an SBR question. But of course, the content is the most important element. In general, the content of a good answer responded to the specific question asked. If the question is asking about impairment, I am writing about something else. It is not relevant. Whether it to be appraise, analyze, discuss, explain anything. Good technique is developed here through practice. You should familiar yourself with the question words used in question, revision question banks, practice exams, identify how the model answers are given. Get into the habit of focusing on the question and within the requirement. You should be prepared to calculate amounts, explain their calculation, analyze the situation to identify relevant points, discuss and reasons for measurement, explain accounting principles and emphasis with stakeholders think. Get into the habit of the focusing on the question word. What the question is actually asking, what is the requirement? Where a numerical answer is required, a good answer shows working in full. Therefore, if you need to multiply share price by the number of shares issued in order to calculate acquisition consideration, you should write this calculation down rather than simply do it in your head. Ki maine number of shares into kar liya, or on your calculator, write it there because it is asking you calculation. This ensures that marks can be awarded even when a final answer has been miscalculated. To save time, bracket shorter workings within the main calculation and so longer working separately. In a written question, a good answer is easy to read, has a logical flaws and leads the reader through your throughout process to show the conclusion recommendation. Plain English, plain simple English and short sentences is the key to a good answer. Avoid overly complex words, sentences, constructions. This often results in the message you want to convey being lost. Because of using wrong English, you may be saying something which you don't want to communicate. It is a good exam technique to get into the habit of briefly planning the content of longer answer. Before writing the answer, think that what you need to write. This will help you avoid the pitfall of the repetition. Writing the same point twice loses valuable time and certainly will not give you any marks. A planning and writing approach that fits any SBR question is state, apply, conclude, approach. State in brief the facts of the scenario, that is, whatever question you are writing, first of all explain the question. State in brief what is asked to you. Then apply whatever the accounting standards IFRS are relevant. Then conclude. Conclude with a recommendation which may be connecting treatment or an action to the taken and as required an impact assessment. An impact assessment on identified stakeholders. As indicated above, in the SBR exam, you are likely to have to consider the effect of an issue and its required approach treatment on given stakeholder groups. For example, a scenario might describe a share-based payment. I'm not going into that because you will be reading that. It's just that I was saying you that what you need to do, which we always discuss, that you have to write the answers according to requirement. You cannot write something which is not asked. The second thing, before writing, plan your answer. And SBR exam is more theoretical than the numerical. In entire paper, maximum 20 to 25 marks will be based on calculation. 75 marks on your theoretical explanation. So that habit we need to develop. We develop the habit, read the question, read the answer, read the question, read the answer. But we don't develop the habit, read the question, writing the answer. Read the question, writing the answer. In place of seeing the solution, write your own answer. That habit need to be developed. Then in that case, by the end when the exam will come, you will be feeling very confident that I can easily pass, I can easily score very good marks. Just by reading the question answers, we cannot pass, we cannot get good marks. There are many materials like this which should be studied by you so that you get hold of the subject. It's not you need to study every day on one single day everything. You need to study on gradual basis. Whenever you are doing a mock paper from the website, when your answer is finished, read the examiner's comment, what they have written. You will find that you are doing the same mistake, so that you will not be doing that same mistake in the exam that is required. So for that reason, my advice to all of you, please understand that if we refer the institute website, everything is there. We don't have to ask anybody on this earth. Nobody. Everything is there written. Now, whether in March 2020, computer-based exam will start or not, that is not yet confirmed. But the institute website is saying. When it is saying, there is 95% confirmity is there. Maybe in March 2020, both options will be there. Like it happened with skill level earlier. Then after some moment, they will say that now the computer-based exam has to be given. But ultimately, all the exams in ACCA will be computer-based. All those students who are in the skill level, who are in the, you can say, knowledge level, I always tell them that abhi professional level ka exam copy pen based hai. When you will reach there, it will be computer based only, because that is the institute guidelines. They want that so that they will make you more computer friendly. Amit, you remember that, sir, I will be giving exam first time on computer based. You were facing problem because you were studying with the physical book, underlining them, not practice the question on the computer screen. That was the issue. I have shared video with all of you yesterday relating to skill level, how they need to study. If the student will not follow my instruction, they will take printout, they will underline, they will solve everything in copy pen. And on the day of exam, they will be taking tension. That is logical that they will be very tensed. The thing which we need to do in the exam need to be followed from today. That is my advice to all of you. Now, as far as the syllabus. This is the study material of the institute. I don't find here the index of the topics. When I'm going through there, then the index of the topics are not there. Now the index of the topics I will make, or you can also make, in which page, which chapter is starting. But in short, I can say that, one second. Up till now, what we have discussed, approach to SBR, that we have discussed. How to study, what is there, regularly visit institute website, that is my first requirement. First thing is the institute website. When everything is available freely, why to ask anybody, kaha hai, kya nahi hai? There are students regularly, yeah, sir, from where I will get the paper, arey bhai, free mein mila hai. The institute website is freely available to you also. Why can't you see? If we can't do this much, then how can we say that we are a good student? And for this, if we say that my office is there, I am not getting time, this is illogical. The second thing, if I will go with the syllabus, I can say that first is IAS 1, IAS 2, IAS 8, IAS 10. Why we need to do this? Because unless and until we know the format of the financial statement, how can we handle the issue? Then comes IFRS 2, share based payments, the way we will be doing in the class. Then comes non-current assets. There are 7-8 IFRS. 7-8. I will consider in this IS 16, IFRS 5, IFRS 8 operating segments, IS 23 borrowing cost, IS 36 intangible assets, impairment, IS 38 intangible assets, IS 20 government grant, IS 40, that is investment property, all is covered under non-current assets. Then comes leasing, which is IFRS, you can see. Leasing IFRS 16. Then comes consolidation. Then comes financial instruments. Then comes revenue recognition. Then comes financial financial statement analysis, which is financial non-financial both. Then theoretical part, which is pure theory. Then mock papers. This is the area which we need to cover in short, I can say. Now understand that in the class which we will be running for 3 months, we are not going to study IS2, IS8, IS10. That we need to do from the past recording. Otherwise, the other important areas I will not be able to cover. I will be going with the format, basic understanding, so that we can understand each topic. That I will take just 10 to 15 minutes. Then I will be going into IFRS2 only. This IS1, IFRS will take around, you can say, along with the today, maybe the next class, half next class. Then this will take, I will not be teaching this one. You need to do with the old recording, because otherwise the important areas we will be missing. Then the non-current assets, we will be doing all the areas which will be taking around 5 to 6 classes. Non-current assets, the different areas. Okay. Leasing we will be doing in one class. Consolidation, we need to take 5 classes. Financial instruments will take 2 classes. Revenue recognition, you need to do with the recording. Financial statement analysis and theory, these two will take, I will say, around 1 class. And then mock papers, you can say 2 classes. These are just my approximate calculation. What I need to say that you should be doing this revenue recognition as a recording. Then theory, as through my notes, I will be explaining, but some reading is required because it is a theoretical concept. Other than that, I will be able to cover in these 3 months. You can understand that 1 class plus 6 class, I am taking the maximum 1 plus 6 is 7 class, plus 1, 8, plus suppose in consolidation 6 class, 8 plus 6, 14, plus 2, 16. Then you can say financial and statement theory is 1, 18, then 2 class is 20. We will get 1 or 2 class extra, that we will be doing mock paper further. Because if we put our time here, IS2, IS8, IS10 and all that, then in that case, in the important areas, we will be not be getting the time. So you should be, from the beginning only, you should keep in your mind that these things I need to do with the recording. And we will be covering the balance portion. When we will be covering, what we will be doing? Suppose I am teaching IFRS2. Suppose I am starting IFRS2. I will explain the concepts fully in the chapter. Whatever each single point is there, I will cover. Okay. Along with that, I will be doing 3-4 questions in the class. Now suppose in the study material, that is in the Kaplan material, suppose when we go into the IFRS 2 CR based payment chapter, there are 10 questions. I have solved 3-4 questions in the class. You need to solve balance questions, not seeing the solution. Solve in writing. Aapko usko likh ke solve karna hoga, then only. There is one more material available for you, which is SBR exam kit. In the kit, there is one detail given relating to each chapter, where the questions are there, in which page, how many questions are there, they have written. I am showing you that page. This is SBR exam kit. Okay. Now suppose I am talking about share based payments. Share-based payments. This is the study chapter 10. The chapter number is written here. Chapter 10. The pocket note chapter 10. We don't have pocket note. My notes is pocket notes. Questions to attempt. Question number 25A. Question number 26A, Roman 2. Question number 25A. Question number 26A, Roman 2. What you will get the knowledge from that question? Date attempted self assessment ki aapne usko kab kiya. So when I am completing the share based payment, you need to do this question also on your own. That means whenever a topic is complete, you need to do the balance questions from the study text, and you need to do the questions from the, you can say, exam kit. That we will be doing along with the class, along with each topic. Once we will finish off the entire syllabus, you can say by 28th or 22nd of August, then last 10 days we will be doing the mock paper combining everything. My target is to complete maximum by, you can say, the non-current assets part, which I am saying, this non-current assets part, 5-6 class and leasing, by the mid of the next month, you can say by July. And then I will be focusing on consolidation and this part in the next month. That is, you can say mid-July to mid-August, maybe around 22nd of August. And then 22nd August, we will be doing the, you can say, the mock papers. Those who are doing the IFRS exam, don't think that your exam is not in September. So you will just do the class sometime, attend and all that. You should be ready by September only, so that in December, you don't take tension. In December, you can give your exam pretty well with confidence and score very high marks, 90 out of 100. Why I will pass only? Everybody should think like that, so that you will be getting all the things ready for your exam. Like I have planned for our class how we will study. Similarly, you need to plan your study. When you will study, when you are your office time, when you are free, at this time you will study. This is your target for this week. A structured study approach need to be there. And whenever you study, don't see the solution. Write the answers. Develop an habit that you will writing the answers. Believe me, not for the exam. You will become a perfect person for handling accounting issues in any organization. High level accounting issues that we require. By the degree that we require, we don't require to pass only. So that is our objective. And last thing. Suppose I am there in question number 25. Suppose I am there in question number 18. Okay. We taught this and you have attempted this question on your own. But you have some problem. You are not understanding what is the question. What you need to do? Print screen. Take a print screen. Paste it here. Paste it here. The print screen question is pasted here. Now, what you think? What is your conclusion? What do you think? And why you are deviating from them? That is, what is your conclusion? you are saying something else, they have written something else, they have done some other calculation, you have done something else. What is your reason? What's the thing? Like that, you need to ask doubts. Maybe you were there in the class or not, that's immaterial. But whatever you have studied, wherever your doubts, don't say me the page number because it will waste our time. Going into the material, opening that, opening the question, opening the page number, then going into answer will waste our time. We want to use our time effectively. So paste the question in the Word file. Write your conclusion, what you think. Write what they have done. Why you are saying that this should be done that way. So that I will be straight away able to focus exactly what you are asking. We can save time. Whenever you are asking a doubt, your doubt should be like this. So that we can clear the doubts in initial 10, 15, 20 minutes. And then we can focus on our syllabus area more and more. I will be able to teach more and more along with your doubt clarification. Maybe if you have doubts sometime when the class is not there in between, you can call me. You can WhatsApp me. If I'm busy, I can connect with you after some time, some later time. Not a problem, but you can always connect with me. You all know that my number is there with you. You can always connect with me for your doubts. I will just request you that whatever you are studying, don't try to come to a conclusion in 1 minute. Make yourself understand the situation, the thing, write something, and then give a mail so that we can discuss properly in the class, so that it will help to everybody. If suppose only Somadevi is studying, it will help to others. If only Tanvi is studying, it will help to others. We need to work as a team, not as a standalone person. So if you give your doubts, then we will discuss in the class. Relating to DIP IFRS exam, the question is, first question is 40 marks, which is full consolidated financial statement, consolidated PL account, balance sheet, anything. Then there are three questions of 20 marks, 20 marks, 20 marks each. The 20 marks questions are very similar to just like strategic business reporting exam, which is of 25 marks. But the first question, which is of 40 marks, which is you can say PL account balance sheet preparation, that is not exactly asked in SBR. It was earlier there in P2 syllabus. When the name changed SBR, they have stopped asking question of PL account balance sheet. They just ask part of that, but whatever part they are asking in SBR, that is only the problem in diploma IFRS in preparing the PL balance sheet. If we focus on the difficult part, we can easily prepare the PL and balance sheet. I'm not saying that we will not do any PL or balance sheet question. We will be doing, but very less. We will be focusing on concepts understanding. PL balance sheet questions are there in my recording. If you have received the recording, there are 10-15 questions I have solved for all PL balance sheet. You can refer them, but in the class, we will not be doing 10-15 PL balance sheet questions because we will not be getting that much time. We will be focusing on SBR syllabus. Whenever I will be teaching something which is not relevant for DIP IFRS, I will be saying that it is not going to come in the exam, it is out of the syllabus. But 90% of the thing are relevant for both of you, the same thing I need to teach. Okay. Now, before proceeding further, do anybody has any question relating to whatever I've not taught any? I've just made the plan. How to study, what to study, how to write the answers, what is your syllabus, how we are going to complete everything. Is there any question before proceeding further? Is there any question before proceeding further? Please don't hesitate. If you don't ask questions, then how I will help you? If there is anything in your mind that you should be knowing, which I have not said relating to your preparation or anything, any general question, so that we can start our study. Anybody? Any question, anything to ask? So we are proceeding, okay? Not a problem, thank you.